How about Joseph Prince? Now, I want to quote what he says, not what he audibly said, because bopake, it's not sure. But let me quote what he says in his book, Destined to Reign. It is also very popular, by the way. It's called the national bestseller. The Secret to Effortless Success, Wholeness, and Victorious Living. So this is his premise. This book enables every follower of God, of Jesus, to have effortless success, wholeness, includes healing, and victorious living. So, God always wants you, if you follow the secret, to have victory, health, success. And he writes, you are destined to reign in life. Now, I think this is true. We will reign with Jesus. But it is true for the future, but not necessarily so for everyone today. But it's very clever to say something that is partially true and apply something that is for the future and say it is for now. He goes on to say, you are called by the Lord to be a success, to enjoy wealth, to enjoy health, and to enjoy a life of victory. Now, let me be clear. Again, I'm not saying that these things are definitely not for any Christian. No, there will be people who are called to such kinds of lives. I'm not against this. God can. But what I'm against is that blind blanket promise to anyone who comes and follows Jesus that this is always going to be your case. That's the problem. So if you're a businessman, God wants you to have a prosperous business. Wow, this one, all the taukes here must be very excited. Now, even though I'm talking about this like he's a false teacher, you still feel, wow, this sounds very good. I want to listen some more. Wow, very gian. You want to hear more of this. So if you're a tauke today, if you're a businessman today, God wants you to have a prosperous business. You will do well in your whatever venture. I can understand why people would love to hear and believe this. It is very tempting. Let's be clear. You almost wish this is true, except that it is not. If you are a homemaker, you are anointed to bring up wonderful children in the Lord. If you are a student, God wants you to excel in all your examinations. How cool is that? Whatever your vocation is, you are destined to reign in life because Jesus is Lord of your life. When you reign in life, you reign over sin. You reign over the powers of darkness. Now, this is very clever. It's true. We are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. You reign, you have power. You don't have to be defeated by sin. You're no more a slave to sin. And what He's saying is true. And then He slips in this part. You have reigned over poverty, over every curse, and over every sickness and disease. So what is right is now coupled with what is not correct, and He sells it to you together, and you say, I want it lock, stock, barrel. Actually, if this is true, New Creation Church should never have anyone who dies. Everyone should live on forever, because you have victory over every disease and every sickness. And it will never be too hard for God to reverse aging anyway. If you believe it, there will be no need for doctors, there will be no need for hospitals. Because God must heal every sickness and disease. Once you know that, you have been forgiven of all your sins, past, present, and future, the healing of all your diseases follows. So no matter how long you have had the problem, No matter how bad the experts say it is, an explosion of healing and restoration will take place, and you will receive what you are believing for. I don't know about you, but when you hear this, it sounds very good. It's extremely alluring and tempting, as I've said. So why do you settle for the curse of disease or sickness or even poverty when the price for your healing and prosperity has been paid by Jesus? We as a nation have been swept. In fact, I think the world today is swept by this feel-good lie of prosperity teaching. It is so far removed from the true gospel of Jesus Christ, it is a damnable heresy. Because it leads people not to value God for who He is, but it leads people to chase after material things of this world, to lead people to idolatry.
Thank you.